The sixth monthly Āradhana of Pujyashree Jayendra Sarasvati Shankaracharya Swami happened at the Shri Kanchi Kamakoti Peetam on the 23rd of August 2018. The Ācharya's Brindavanam sits atop a beautiful tortoise. The tulasi flourishes on top. The iconography on the Adhishthanam is that of Rajagopala from Mannargudi, which is near Irulniki, where His Holiness was born. Rajagopala was chosen because His Holiness did so much for the protection of the cow. The Sri Kamakshi Seva Samiti offered a gold necklace to His Holiness with Chandrashekhara Pahimam and Chandrashekhara Rakshamam on either side, holding a gold Kamakshi in between. For His Holiness, even the simplest beads and baubles strung in nylon wire offered by a devotee with love was as important as that with precious stones and gold. His Holiness always stood by and behind His Guru with great reverence. He continues to do so in the Adhishthanam, chosen by Mahaperiva and groomed by him. He spent his life fulfilling Mahaperiva's wishes. Mahaperiva's Adhishthanam's iconography is that of a Navaneeta Krishna. Both Adhishthanams are decorated for this Aradhana, where the Gurus are honored and their blessings sought by the devotees. Adi Shankara, the first Guru of this Peetham, sits alongside Mahaperiva, the 68th Guru, on the silver swing offered by the Suvasinis. The preparations for the puja begin. The place is cleaned and a kolam is put for the kalasham, that is to hold Narayana. This water that becomes Narayana is called Tirtha Narayana. Once it is adorned with vastrams, the sankalpam is taken. A sannyasi has no family. Sri Ramakrishna, who was the brother of His Holiness before he took up the sannyasam, that is to say, his Purva Ashrama brother, performs the puja to Tirtha Narayana. It is not for the divine. It is not for His Holiness. Rather, it is for the individual and the devotees that this is done. The sankalpam that is stated is a resolve that states that the individual will certainly perform the proposed action at that particular date and time. In this case, during the Shukla Paksha Trayodashi, the resolve is to perform the Tirtha Narayana Puja with a Shodashopachara, the 16 stages of a puja with offerings. Four planks are placed to seat the Brahmanas who represent the Guru, the Paramaguru, the Parameshti Guru and the Paratpara Guru. The other Yattis or Sannyasis who have come to the Sri Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham for Chaturmasyam attend the Aradhana Puja. The four Brahmanas arrive. They are not mere Brahmanas today. They represent the lineage of the Guru Shishya Parampara up to the last four generations of Gurus. This is why their feet were anointed with sandal paste, and then the water that is washed from their big toe on the right foot is taken, collected and put in the kalasham as the sacred water. Our culture is all about symbolism and intention. We believe that anything said, done, invoked with real intent and real feeling will actually happen as a reality. This is why we often bathe saying Gangecha Yamune Chaiva Godavari Saraswati Narmade Sindhu Kaveri Jalesmin Sannidhim Kuru. We invoked all the waters of the sacred rivers into our bath water. It is believed that the devis come and they make our bath water sacred. Similarly, when we pray and we immerse ourselves in a river, the prayer that goes to the river purifies it in turn. This is why they found that E. coli bacteria cannot survive in the Ganga. However, it survives in every other river all over the world, causing a lot of sickness. Ganga Jalam, no matter when you drink it, only cures you and purifies you and never harms you. Such is the power of intent. And this is what we do when we invoke the divine in a kalasham and we invoke the gurus in the seated brahmanas, as it is during the Aradhana, or invoke our ancestors in the seated brahmanas during our own shradham. We have to give them all the attention and care as though, and not even as though, as the one we have invoked have really come to grace us with their presence. Now that the Shodashopachara puja is over, the cloth is removed, carefully wrapped into a bundle and placed on Sri Ramakrishnan's head. The kalasham then has to be carefully nestled in this. Sri Ramakrishnan will carry it, performing a pradakshanam, circumambulating the four gurus who are seated and the two adhishthanams. Everyone will follow behind.
Krishna Govinda, Krishna Keshava Govinda.
The water is first splashed on the 70th Ācharya, Jagadguru, Pujyashree Shankaracharya Sarasvati's shiras. After receiving these blessings, the other yatis follow to receive the blessings. This water is then sprinkled on the members of His Holiness Jayendra Periva's Purvashrama family and then to other bhaktas. Duly anointed with sandal paste, garlanded, honored, fanned, and taken care of, the Brahmanas are given akshata with which to bless Sri Ramakrishnan and his family. Once again, we must remember that they represent the Guru, the Paramaguru, the Parameshti Guru, and the Paratpara Guru. With the chanting of Veda mantras, they transfer their blessings through the akshata. This akshata infused with blessings is collected. It is transferred into a vessel. The vessel is kept in front of His Holiness Periva. Periva first takes a few grains of those akshata and places it on his own shiras to receive the blessings of his guru. After he does this, he gives the blessings to all the devotees present. As is convention, people don't receive it in their hands. They receive the blessings in their vastrams. The reason we traditionally receive things like blessings in our vastram, the talapu or the end cloth for women and the end of the angavastram for men, is so that not even a small shred, a particle of the blessing would fall to the floor or to ensure that there would not be a slip of the hand, so to speak. And thus, on this auspicious note, with the blessings given to all the devotees present, the 6th monthly Āradhana of the 69th Ācharya of the Sri Kanchi Kamakoti Peetam, Jagadguru Puja Sri Jayendra Saraswati Shankaracharya Swami, was performed. Jaya Jaya Shankara, Hara Hara Shankara.